Hey guys, it's Captain Walnut, and we are back. No, I don't have an awesome blaze farm to show you like I promised. No, I don't have an awesome diamond farm to show you like I promised. And there's a very good reason for all of that. And that is because we had a bunch of server glitches and some really massive problems with our old hosting service. We were going through Creeper Host, and I had a 4 GB server. And that one was just, it's 4 GB, right? Which, you know, Feed the Beast needs a lot of memory, but 4 GB should have been more than enough. And it was just crashing and overflowing all the time. So we switched back to a host that I've used before that I really like, Daddy Cheese. And, we only have a 2 GB server on this one, and it's running like a boss. So unfortunately, because of all that crashing and corruption and stuff like that, we had to start a brand new map. So that's kind of sad, but it does give us a chance to get started over again. So those of you who are commenting on my last video that already won the game on my first episode, last one, I'm going to caution you, I've kind of done the same thing again. I swear I meant to be recording this entire time, but most of the time I play very late at night when I'm half asleep, so that wouldn't have made for very good recording. But yeah, so here is my temporary base I've got set up here. You see that totem over there? I got a portal gun from that totem. And I'm having weird loading issues, world loading issues. But I got a totem from that, I got a portal gun from that totem. And also this valley is gorgeous, so I figured that was good luck and I should settle here. So I built myself a temporary base here. I got, you know, a big old quarry going here with all my barrels like I do. With the relays and the red power pipes and all that good stuff. Lava powered with magmatic engines like I do. The core is already done. But and then I have every machine that you could ever want here. all jammed into one teeny tiny little space with a bunch of thermal generators going for it. And it looks like everybody, you see there's a portal gun portal there, portal there, portal there. It looks like everybody and their mom is portaling to my base to use my machines. So yeah. But I do have a little piece of footage to show you. Well, before we get to that, I want to talk about my power source. And my plans for this base. So first we'll get to the power source. Let's go over here. Now the plans for the base, you can see, you know me, I'm usually very clean cut and squared off and a little OCD about my builds. With this new map, I want to try and get away from that. I want to try to have a little bit more randomness, a little bit, you know, so I can go crazy a little bit, do whatever I want, not be stuck into the strictures of perfectly square and everything perfectly symmetrical and stuff like that. And I don't mean, like, laid out random. Like, I think this is ugly right here, and I think just having those blast furnace and the creosote oven, just, I think that's just disgusting, and having this pipe running across the surface. No, no, I don't mean things like that. Like, I want to have, like, a nice little tower, you know, but not perfectly shaped with, like, maybe looking a little rickety going up there. If you watch B00 and Generic B, holy crap am I being inspired by that building structure. The B team on the FTB server. The Mindcrack FTB server. But I'm being way inspired by those guys. So you might recognize this power source. It's the power source I was running on the old FTB server. But there seems to be a problem. You see how everything's just a little bit dark? Go and turn on this light here. And this light over here. Everything's a little bit dark right now. And there's a really good reason for that. No steam, no fuel. And you know why? There's no scrap over here. Nothing whatsoever. I don't understand why there's like a couple scrap that's ready to be made if there only there was some power. But I don't understand. I think in one of the intervening updates, because this was working here, you can see it was working very well with using scrap to produce Minecraft jewels through a boiler like I used to. Because you can see it filled up this lava tank completely, and then I was taking out from that lava tank to power everything else, like my quarry and all my machines down there. And there's still plenty of lava in there. It's basically one giant battery. So there's plenty of lava in there to run off this for a while, so I don't need to be worried quite yet about any power issues. But I think there's an update where the scrap production rate, either in recyclers or the burning rate of scrap in boilers, has changed that broke this. So I actually need to change up my power source, and I have some pretty good ideas on that. I'm gonna go, I think, methane power. I still want to stick with the whole steampunk idea. Well, not steampunk, but I still love boilers, but I'm just gonna change what powers them. I'm gonna go with some methane, which I get from pumpkins. So I got some footage that I recorded in the past about that, with everyone sort of derping around on chat while I was building the pumpkin farm. So we'll cut to that, and I'll see you guys in a bit. How's Thaumcraft going, Brett?
Fine.
What's your plan for Thaumcraft? What are you planning on doing with it?
I want to make my special wands that make zombies.
Ooh. A little that army. So if we ever do a big giant PvP tournament, you'll just be like, fuck your face.
Or if anybody's bothering me.
Oh, so you mean you can just go troll Sam?
Yeah, probably.
Both of them.
Hey.
Well, it's your own fault for, like, being alive, you know?
Same, I should, like, not be alive.
Dude.
That's hot.
What is that? What are you telling? I'm not getting out of my Minecraft. Like, no, I'm not. Is you send me a picture or something? I'm not getting out of the call. Look at your gay little picture. Is it of a black person again?
No.
You racist motherfucker.
I was just...
Oh my god, he's so black! I mean, there's black people, but then this one, this guy is so black. Oh, it's so creepy. I can't believe you were doing that, like, all day yesterday. You and Sam One were just... Oh my gosh.
Did you see the picture?
No!
No, it's so black! No, honestly, so black.
You're ridiculous.
I just looked at the picture again.
Oh my god.
I don't have an aneurysm now.
Yeah, seriously.
He's wearing a white shirt as well. look at that, guys.
No. I'm not going to look at any pictures you send me. I've stopped looking at the links that you guys put in Skype a long time ago.
Wait for Sam to be like, WTF. I can't stop laughing.
Hey, how do you make... No, I'll just look it up, never mind.
You guys bullying Sam.
Yep.
That they were saying that I have no friends.
No, we were just saying that
okay,
that he has no partners in crime. He was begging me to come over and help him with stuff, and I was like, I'm helping Brett because he's my partner in crime. You need to get your own partner in crime.
Hang on, Sam, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
How many freckles do you have?
How many souls have you stolen?
I actually lost count quite a few years ago.
Yeah, I'm going back.
Where's the map? He just came on to say that.
I need paper.
I just thought there was a hurricane where Brett was.
Just like England got bombed and disappeared the other day. You guys all signed off at the same time, independently of each other. It was just boom, 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 boom. Oh, okay, England's gone.
Apparently everyone has like popped on again. How do you power a steam engine?
Make sure it's the red and orange type, or red and yellow type, not the other types.
Yeah.
And That one takes any solid fuel like coal or wood or anything you can put in a furnace, basically.
Are they really efficient?
What's nice about them is when you hook them up directly to thermal expansion devices or through an energy conduit to one of them, once that device is full, they'll actually cut back on their power usage to minimum power. So, like, for instance, I think the steam engine normally produces 2 MJ per tick. Whatever it's powering, if it happens to be thermal expansion stuff, once it's done, once those are full, it'll cut back down to like 0.2 MJ per tick. So it'll stop using as much energy. So that way you don't have to constantly turn it on and off. But you can still turn it on and off to save all the energy if you want to, which is nice. Make sure you supply it water though, so you might want an aqueous accumulator with it. One aqueous accumulator can service a couple of steam engines.
Alright, and then, do I need it next to a water source?
Yeah, the aqueous accumulator, you need a water block on each side of it, water source block.
On every side or just on one side?
On two sides.
Okay.
You know, Sam, you should really listen to your mother better.
Yeah, you should.
Shut up, guys. Look at this kid, yeah? Look at him.
I'm not gonna look at any of your pictures.
I was talking about mom.
Oh.
I'm telling you, we don't watch gay porn.
Oh my goodness, Sam, are you on about that again?
Why?
Oh my god, you have a problem.
My mom finds it funny.
Oh my goodness. If you knew how much he was going on about this little black kid. And I quote, I mean, I've seen black kids, but this guy's black.
Breathe.
Yeah.
Breathe. Can we get you a paper bag?
Hey there, Chris. Sam. What is... So they say for every soul you steal, you get another freckle, right? How many freckles do you have for stealing an old man's virginity?
That's disgusting.
That's so creepy.
Ugh, man, my mouth is dry. I can't do it with my monitor.
Try and seduce Kurt with that voice.
Yeah, you have to sing this song.
Oh, dude, Soren, me and you know this.
I wanna scream and shout and let it all
out. Oh my
god. And scream and shout and let it out. You say, oh, we are.
And I'm not rocking with.
We're like Captain Herbert, bitch.
Chris Griffin and Herbert, bitch.
Oh my gosh. So I built this thing at Brett's house because I actually started this project a long time before I knew that I was going to need to build an alternate power source. And I'm building it at Brett's house because not only does he need tons of energy, but I was going to set up a bunch of stuff here too. Brett and I are sort of partners in crime on this server. He's going to be doing the bees and the forestry and the thomcraft, and I'm going to be doing all the industrial craft and build craft and basically the power and the machines. He's got the natcher and the magic, and I got the power and the machines. So I built this thing over here. And yeah, surprise, surprise, he built in a volcano. He hauled out a volcano and built inside of it. So I'm setting this thing up over here. And let me just say, 1 second. Recording. Yeah. And I gotta warn you guys, it's pretty complex. So, I left part of the floor exposed over on this side so I could show you how this thing works, and I'm going to attempt to explain this thing in as much detail as possible. I have two boilers going here with tanks feeding them, and then a power room over here, and I'll get into detail on all of this. And then here's all my levels of pumpkins that you saw me building. So, for those of you who are curious about these pumpkin, these melon harvesters, these pumpkin harvesters, they can do two blocks below. So you notice here it's even with that, and then one two-block space, as illustrated by that lamp. And then the same level they're on, and then 10 blocks above them. So basically I have two of them to service this whole thing. And then a 21 by 21 square around them in that entire 12 or really 13 block high space. All right, so warning, there is some math ahead about, we're about to do some math about all this stuff. Okay, so you might be saying, why aren't you using a gas turbine? Because one methane in a gas turbine is worth 45,000 EU. Well, you're leaving energy on the table if you use the gas turbine. You can really get more energy out of a boiler because once it's fully heated, just because it's so complicated to set up that it makes sense that you should be able to get some sort of efficiency advantage. So one methane produces 6,000 heat in a boiler because boilers work in heat units basically. In a 36 tank high pressure boiler, which is what I have right here, consumes 15.84 heat every tick. And since there's 20 ticks in a second, that means one methane is consumed every 18.9 seconds. And hopefully I'll be able to get some numbers up here on the screen to help me explain this. But yeah, so 18.9 seconds or so. So what does that mean in terms of EU? A 36 tank high pressure boiler produces 720 steam per tick. And 5 steam equals 1 Minecraft joule in one of these steam engines here. So like one of these, any of these types of steam engines that interface with the boiler, it equals 5 of the steam equals 1 Minecraft joule. So that makes sense, right? So that means a boiler produces 144 Minecraft joules per tick, so 2,880 Minecraft joules per second. So since a methane is consumed in 18.9 or so seconds, that means that each methane is worth 54,545.5 Minecraft joules. Now we convert to EU using crucibles, so these little magma crucibles fed by cobble and some buildcraft energy into EU. So it converts that into lava, and the lava is turned into EU using thermal generators. So if it takes 24,000 Minecraft joules to produce one lava in a crucible here, and one lava is worth 30,000 EU in a thermal generator, that means one Minecraft joule equals 1.25 EUs. So, therefore, one methane in a boiler is worth 68,181 EU. So, versus that 45,000 EU that we would have only gotten if we used a gas turbine, that's a difference of 23,181 EU. So definitely would have been leaving energy on the table if you didn't use a boiler and just use a gas turbine instead. Now, this setup right here, with the two boilers I have going on, has a maximum production rate because we're talking about heat consumption per tick and stuff like that. So that means there is a maximum rate that you can get out of this thing. And that is, I won't lead you through all the math, that's just 7,680 EU per second out of both of these boilers. So that's still a butt ton of energy. That's a lot of energy. It's more energy than you'll really be able to use, except, of course, if you're using a matter fabricator or a mass fabricator, whatever the heck they're called. Okay, so how do we get the methane in the first place? You notice here that I got pumpkins going. So first off, you saw that I had the pumpkins coming from down here in these little melon guys going into a relay because they just eject into any inventories that are next to them. The relay sends it up the pneumatic tubes into another relay, which continues it up going to a chest here, right? Once this chest, every slot is occupied in this chest. You know, there's only 14 here, but the slots aren't occupied anymore. Then this gate here, if the inventory is full, it produces a redstone signal. So it would produce a redstone signal, which turns off this redstone energy cell. So basically, it stops the harvesting process. It basically prevents energy from being wasted. I'm actually pretty proud of that, surprisingly enough. But yeah, so once this chest is full, meaning that all of my centrifuges are full, we stop harvesting pumpkins. So you notice that I started needing pumpkins again. Some more are coming up, and they're coming up very quickly. I'm only giving each of those two of them 3 Minecraft jewels per tick, so it's barely any energy usage at all. Got a filter here, sitting at 16 pumpkins at a time with a timer delay of, let's see if I can see it here, 8 seconds. That's fast enough to fill each of these up without going too fast to cause backstuffing and stuff like that. But yeah, so you notice that I have 14 centrifuges servicing each boiler, so 14 on this side servicing that boiler, 14 on this side servicing that boiler, and that is because if we look at the recipe here, come on, give me it, there we go, 16 pumpkins is worth 1 methane, and there it was, and it takes 250 seconds to do that. So it takes 250 seconds to do that, right? Now, like we said earlier, a methane is consumed every 18.9 seconds in that these guys, and it's produced every 250 seconds, so 250 divided by 18.9 is 13.2. It means I need 13.2 centrifuges to keep up, so we round up, of course, to get 14. That means that I'm going to produce a slight surplus of methane, which I'm storing in this tank here. The last time I was here, I was at 287,000 methane, so you can see that I'm very slowly increasing. I'm at 468,000 right now. So yeah. And then before I get into the networking, one last note on numbers, and the last bit of mathing that we're going to do is, how do I know how many steam engines I should hook up to each of these boilers? How many is too many? How few is too few? What's the best way to get the maximum amount out? Well, so you have you have 3 types of steam engines: the industrial steam engine, which produces 8 Minecraft joules per tick, the commercial steam engine, which produces 4, and the hobbyist, which produces 2 Minecraft joules per tick. So since the boiler produces 144 Minecraft joules per tick, that means it can support up to 18 industrial steam engines, right? But you don't want to grab all of that. You want to stay slightly underneath it to make sure there's at least a little surplus of fuel, just in case there's some rounding errors or something in the calculation. So you can see here that I'm constantly bouncing just below the maximum steam that these guys can store. That's because I'm using 16 industrials, 2 commercials, so basically 17 industrials, and then 1 these little guys, or really 3 commercials, and then 1 of these little hobbyists. So these are industrial steam engines along the sides, 3 commercials across the top and the back, and then 1 hobbyist here. So I'm really using 142 Minecraft joules per tick when it can produce 144. So I'm staying just underneath it. So that's all I'm going to say about numbers and stuff like that. And then all that's flowing into these energy conduits. The energy conduit comes down here, down that part right there, and flows out. Goes into the energy cell to power everything else down there. And then also flows left and right to power not only the liquid transposer, but also all of this junk here. And look, my lava tank's almost full. Yay! And then I got these color coatings going on with the pneumatic tubes. I guess the easiest place to start is with the pumpkins. So pumpkins, and hopefully you can see it, I gave an orange tube coloring. So if you look at the filter, you see you can choose a color. A color on a pneumatic tube will prevent things that are colored differently from passing through it. So things that don't have a color can pass through this, but things that have a different color, such as this magenta or that white, will not be able to pass through there. So the pumpkins go through, and I have the piping set up like this, separated out with some of these covers so they don't join, so that way each of these centrifuges is equidistant from the that thing over there, so each of these centrifuges has a equal chance of getting filled up, so that way they all get filled up at the same rate instead of starting in the middle and then working its way outward. Okay. So once those things are produced, I have these guys, these filters, on a, I think, 30-second timer over here. What is that? Yeah, 30-second timer. They're colored magenta, and when they come out, they go over here, and look, some just came out. How convenient. They come down the corner, they flow over here, and then they come all the way over to this intersection right here. They can only flow up into this relay, which immediately injects them into the liquid transposer. So you'll see here, there they go up into the relay. You can see the relay starts. Well, it's not doing the animation, but it injects them into the liquid transposer. You see that? The liquid transposer I have configured to accept from the left, eject empty cans to the right, so into this chest here. Then a filter colors them white and spits them out. So that goes back down along the bottom, and it doesn't really matter about equal opportunity with the empty cans, since there's plenty of buffer on that. So they just go into the bottoms there, and I guess I didn't need to cover every single one of them white. Notice I have orange back there, too. So they have equal chance of going into there, but they won't flow across this orange section here in the middle. And that's the important part, is that the cans always stay on the same side. So that way, if I wanted to turn one boiler off for some reason to do, like, maintenance or something, I could, and I wouldn't have to worry about empties flowing across to the side that I'm doing maintenance on. Same setup over here under the ground. And then let's talk about this room over here now. So I have these four thermal generators. You really only need two, or really 2.2, but I'm doing four dedicated to powering this side, and it all goes up into an MFE. That way I will never get an insufficient energy problem from one of these guys, and also there's a little bit of buffer in case I'm drawing more power than my boilers can produce at any given point in time. Then there's no problem keeping these guys powered for a short period of time. And then these eight here are dedicated to outside power. So I have this whole array of crucibles. It's more crucibles than you need. I think by what? How many can it power? I don't even remember how many can power. I don't have my notes in front of me. But yeah, that's more crucibles than you need, but that's okay. That makes sure that I produce lava at a pretty constant rate instead of in fits and starts. And then here, these eight are dedicated to the outside. These four are dedicated to the all equipment inside here. And you can see that this wire goes along here, goes down into an MFE, which goes underground. And let's just jump down in there. Or maybe we should jump down right here. That'd probably be easier. Yeah. Okay. So that wire flows along here, goes into an MFSU, joins up with the wire from the other side. The MSU goes up top. So let me fly back out of here. Put these blocks back. Okay. So there's that MFSU. That provides plenty of buffer energy for any purposes, and then all that flows up and out there over to Brett's base. So you can see it, just a long tunnel for the wire all the way over to Brett's base. That is this entire setup. I hope that all made sense to you guys. And I have a little bit of footage here that I want to show you for why I was so eager to get this thing set up. Be back with you after that. Alright guys, and now we're going to build the fabricator, the matter fabricator. So if I look in here at the recipe, here's all the stuff I need. Let's go ahead and make these energy flow circuits first. So to get those, I basically just need, I'll do the one that gets me four. So I need an iridium plate in the middle. And then you can see that I can have an advanced circuit in the corners, as well as two Lapitron crystals. So let's get the tungsten going. And you can see here I've gathered all the materials I'm going to need. So let's just drop the tungsten in there, and it should go. That's going to take a little while. So now let's go ahead and make these Lapitrons. Here we go. This is everything I need to make the Lapitron crystals. If I look at the recipe for a Lapitron crystal, you can see here that I can do it with lapis and sapphires, as well as just regular circuits on the top and bottom. So let's grab all that stuff. Okay, go over to a project table. Sapphires in the middle, and then 10 of these guys, 8, 9, 10, 7, 8, 10, there we go, and then here we go, there's Lapitron crystals. Alright, and yes, I want to finish that out. Okie dokes. So go ahead and put that into here and here, because what this guy right here is eventually going to be is, right? Yeah, no, that's right. And then the tungsten will go here and here. Okay, so, is that tungsten ready yet? No, it's not. Okay, well, we can just go ahead and move on to making this one, which is these, teleporters. So, need two frequency transmitters. So I'll go ahead and make those real quick, in case you don't know how to make them. They are super simple, just like this. There's one, there's two. Okay. Then I'll just grab this other stuff. Okay. Put that in there. 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 And there, right? Oh, as well as the frequency transmitter. Okay, one, two. Awesome. So there's my teleporters. Okay, so now we'll start assembling the final frame here. Let's get these highly advanced machine blocks. Need chrome and titanium. So I haven't made my chrome yet. I should have gone ahead and done that. That was dumb of me. And I need this guy? Right? Make sure that's what I need. Yes, I do need the industrial blast furnace. Okay, well, we're just gonna have to wait on that then. what else can I make while we're sitting here waiting? Looks like nothing. Right, well, I'll get back with you guys once I've made this chrome and once the tungsten is done. Okay, there's the last one. And, so I need these guys. And I can go ahead and put these in there. I'll come back and make that in a second before I forget how to make these. So here, hopefully I'm not doing this backwards. Of course I am. These switch. There we go. Highly advanced machine frames. Okay. So these go here and here. Alright, so let's go ahead and make those energy flow circuits, right? That's what they're called. Yep, let's go ahead and make those. Iridium in the middle. A Lapitron on each side. Tungsten above and below. And advanced circuits here, here, and here. There's my four energy flow circuits. Okay. Boom, 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 boom. Then finally, I need to build this guy, the Lapitronic Energy Orb. Just an iridium plate surrounded with a bunch of Lapitron crystals. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay. And this will do it for me, I think. Done. Alright. So, that right there is the matter fabricator. So yeah, let's go ahead and grab it and put it together. Put that in the middle. Alright guys, this has been the culmination of a lifetime of work. Oh my goodness. Yes. Right there. Yes. Throw it at the screen. Oh, that's so nice. Okay, made the matter fabricator. Putting that away before something bad happens to it. Okay. Oh, boy. Well, guys, that is it. Thank you very much for watching. Next week, or next time I post, we'll probably have that matter fab setup that I just showed you. Here's the room completely all closed up, looking all schmexer. Yeah. Okay. Yep, again, thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you all later. Bye-bye.